Hey, what's going on, guys? Vega here from SerpentX Tech, and in this video, I'm going to go over my top 5 apps that every crypto miner should have or should be utilizing to help you manage, monitor, and maintain your mining rigs. Because not only is efficiency super important, but uptime is as well. And one of the first categories that I have to go over is mining monitors. There's a whole host of these out there. Normally, what I would recommend is to try to get the official application from the company or miner program or whatever you're using. But 9 times out of 10, those actual companies are using subsidiary or a different name to make those apps. So just be careful. But for example, F2Pool, you can see that this app specifically is made by F2Pool Inc. If you can get it from an official source, go for it. Otherwise, just verify it is a legit app that you're getting. So first off, HiveOS is a great application, and many of the miners out there, specifically more advanced miners, just above entry level, right? So not the average user, because the average user is probably using Windows. The next stage up, people are using mining operating systems like HiveOS, MinerStat, whatever it may be. And you can see that it's offered not only for Apple iOS, but Android as well. And what I would recommend is that app pretty much does everything, right? You can manage your rigs, you can restart your rigs, you can remotely load up a shell, do whatever you need to, and then monitor, of course, your hash rate on the pool if you're mining to Hiveon. However, there's other pools available, and this monitor right here called Mining Monitor for Ethereum is actually pretty good. Just look for this icon. You can load up your Ethereum Classic or Ethereum address, see your hash rate, see your workers, see what's going on, and that kind of tells you what's up. Also, some of these pools offer, like Ethermine, offer a way that if your worker drops offline, it would notify you. And I recommend doing that, because then at least you know, hey, my rig's offline, and then you can use other apps that I'm gonna go over to manage, maintain, or whatever it may be. MinerStat, another Linux or Unix-based operating system. Hive OS is really good. NiceHash is very popular, though. There's a Windows version. There's a NiceHash OS, again, built on Linux or Unix. And it can get the job done, but it's more for the entry level. Again, as I see, everybody might start off at NiceHash or direct mining, what I call batch file mining, and then switch over to HiveOS. And then FlexPool Monitor, obviously, for that pool, if you're mining to FlexPool, you can monitor your rigs, your hash rates, everything as well. Probably get the same notifications that Ethermine has when your worker goes offline. So some type of mining monitor for the pool you're on, for the program you're using, is very good, so that way you can maintain what the status is of your systems. Next one is wallets. This is going to be a very big one. My favorite wallets are obviously MetaMask and Ledger, but there's a lot of Web3 wallets out there that's available. I do have Konami and a bunch of mobile wallets as well, but I try to keep it condensed because I don't want too many wallets, right? So at the very beginning of Bitcoin, I had so many different wallets. It's very hard to manage and maintain or just know where my funds are. So I kind of condensed it a little bit. Ledger or hardware wallet would be one of my favorites for long-term storage, cold storage. Especially for funds that are growing and growing. You don't want to keep thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands on an exchange. You really want to keep in a cold storage in a wallet that you have control of. Exodus is very good. MetaMask, Trust. Obviously, we got Binance Chain. That's not Binance itself, but that's Binance Smart Chain, the wallet. Atomic, a lot of people like Windows-based applications, GUIs. Atomic has it. Exodus has it. Ledger does have it. I believe Trust does have it. I'm not sure. I don't really use Trust as much, but I heard nothing but good things from them. Konami has a desktop wallet, but it's very glitchy. But the mobile wallet's perfectly fine. This one is specifically a Bitcoin wallet, so is Luno. And then Zellcore is a very good GUI wallet, and it offers a lot of assets, allows you to claim any other, like if you hold Flux and you might be airdrop XYZ coin, Zellcore will allow you to, record that, or they would use your snapshot to claim those funds based upon what you held in your wallet. So really, I talked about crypto wallets and what the best are in the past. This isn't this type of video. I just wanted to showcase, Web3 is really good. Hardware wallets are really good. Cold storage are very good for large amounts of funds. Otherwise, a desktop wallet or mobile wallet that's capable for your systems is very good. And again, these are available not only for iOS, but as well for Android, okay? So just make sure you get whatever you're comfortable with. MetaMask is certainly one of the most popular wallets out there. Moving on, we got exchanges. These exchanges are available on mobile. Yes, you can access for desktop, and mostly everything that I'm showing you in this video, you can access on desktop. But you want to maintain your exchanges, right? Especially if you're a nice hash miner and you want to, you automatically exchange or withdraw your funds to Coinbase, you want to keep an eye on that, right? So you keep your Coinbase, your crypto.com, your Binance on your phone so that way you can manage, see your funds, send, receive, whatever it may be. Again, you're keeping your funds on an exchange, which I recommend against. But if you're doing some quick trading, quick swapping, quick send and receive, then it's perfectly fine. Kraken is one that I personally like. Coinbase, everybody in the U.S. has it, or pretty much everybody in the U.S. has it. Crypto.com is becoming that main staple in the crypto community, certainly growing here in the States. And then you obviously have other exchanges that may be supported. You just got to get what's supported in your area. Not all exchanges are supported everywhere, but most of these that you see on here are Hibou, Gemini, big in the States, Celsius, BlockFi, Bitstamp, HIT, BTC, and KuCoin. But obviously, just making sure you have those exchanges on your smartphone would help you out in maintaining your funds. Then there's remote access, right? So say, for example, we're using our monitoring service to manage or see what our hash rates are, that our workers are online, that we're submitting shares. Well, what happens when it goes down? Well, if you're on a Windows system, then you're going to need something remote access, right? If you're on Hive, you probably won't need to do it because Hive itself has built-in remote capabilities via shell. But if you're on Windows, you know, there's remote desktop, the normal remote desktop, or RDP as we call it, for Microsoft. There's Chrome remote desktop. Obviously, that's very dependent as far as security upon the security of your account, your Gmail, right? So if you don't have two-factor authentication, your Gmail is connected to a bunch of computers, I would be very careful. Do not use that. Any desk is pretty good. That's a software that a few of the crypto community members that I know use to quickly remote in and see what the hash rates are of a particular GPU. Splashtop, I heard, was pretty good. And then TeamViewer. Now, TeamViewer I used a lot in the past, but as it's grown, it's gotten all Hollywood on me and is wanting more and more money for a subscription. So, you know, I've kind of transitioned to some other applications or remote desktop apps that I can utilize. Then I like to keep an eye on the market. Now, yes, you can go to your Safari browser, your Google Chrome, whatever it may be. But I like to keep an eye on, you know, CoinMarketCap is one of my favorite applications to keep an eye on for, you know, coin tracking. CoinGecko is really good. Coin360 is really good. But you just want to make sure you're monitoring the markets. Now, the good thing is, like, say, for example, TradingView, you can set an alert. And so when they, you know, you set a price target, obviously there's free and there's paid. If you have so many signals, so many XYZ indicators on, and you want to have alerts for multiple coins, then you're going to have to pay a subscription. But otherwise, if you just use the free one and say, you know, set Bitcoin at 42,000, if it drops below 42,000, it will alert you. You can do that. That's very useful. These other applications can kind of do the same thing. Coin Tracker and Coin Tracking are two different things from the rest of the apps. What they actually do is they help you manage your money. You know, track your sending, receiving, your transactions completed. And CoinTracker.io is one, I believe this is in my description, because it's good for tax purposes, right? Because you're gonna have to verify all of your transactions, provide that to your lawmakers and your local government, verifying that, you know, you paid XYZ, here's my transactions over the past year. And this is a good utility to manage and maintain that. You can connect it to Coinbase and a number of other exchanges, but obviously, again, you're gonna have to find the right one for your area, your country, your region. And then last but not least, some bonus tools and utilities that I like to use. I like Pulseway. Pulseway is a tool that I can install the management tool on a particular computer like my NAS or my Windows mining rigs. And if the system goes down, it will let me know. If there's a Windows critical update, it will let me know. It gives us multiple notifications and multiple features that we can really use. It's really for a sysadmin or network admin to manage a bunch of computers for a company, but it can be deployed in such a way to help you out, especially if you're Windows mining and maintaining those rigs, making sure that they're up to date, make sure there's no critical issues, hardware issues, whatever it may be. Glasswire, very good for maintaining the network of your house or your location. It lets you know what's been kicked on, what's been kicked off, what type of TCP, UDP connections you have. If there's anything mysterious showing up, it will kind of alert you. It does have a free and paid. If you do paid, then you have virus total enabled, which will keep an eye on things. Like if my son's going to crazy sites and downloading stuff, don't want to infect the rest of my network, so it shuts it down or alerts me to it. Speed test, everybody knows you always want to make sure that your network speed is good. So I use my mobile phone. Like if I'm at a new location setting up rigs, I might use my mobile phone to test the speeds. 9 times out of 10, you're not using wireless, though. If you're on HiveOS, you're directly wired, but it is good to know what the Wi-Fi speeds are and to know what channels are good. So Wi-Fi Analyzer lets you know if you are using Wi-Fi, you know, what channels are good, what in the bands of 2.4 gig, 5 gig, so on and so forth. Asus router is one of my favorites, but that's because I have an Asus router. Obviously, you might have TrendNet or whatever it may be. Get one that's best for your setup or your home network or small office network, and then you'll be able to manage, you know, connectivity, right? All right, I don't know this rig. I don't know this MAC address. Who's this on the network? You know, Glasswire can not only help you alert to a situation where someone's on the network that shouldn't be, but then you can use your router to block, ban, whitelist, blacklist, whatever it may be. And then another network analyzer does the same thing just to maintain and monitor your network. So my top five apps, in short, in summary, is have a mining monitor. If you're using HiveOS, great. You could do everything in one suite or one app. If you're using NiceHash, Windows, or the OS, you can manage everything from there as well. You can't do too much. You can't remote in or anything like that. But like you can't do as much as HiveOS, but you can certainly monitor what's going on. Or if you're mining on an open Ethereum pool and you have the address, you could see it with mining monitor or Flex pool or F2 pool, whatever it may be. Then obviously select the wallets that best suit your conditions. Don't get crazy and download all the wallets that are out there. Just stick to a primary few. Obviously make sure it's secure. Make sure you're enabling two-factor authentication when available. All of these apps should have it. Not all of them do though. If you're going to use Web3, make sure you're getting the official MetaMask, because there have been scams in the past where they're spoofing. Then exchanges, choose your favorite exchanges that are supported your country, region, or area. So that way you can maintain, manage, and send and receive funds. And then obviously remote access from our Windows users, not necessary for my HiveOS or mining operating system users. AnyDesk, TeamViewer, regular RDP, or Google Chrome, SplashTop, whichever you like. And then of course, track the market, where there's CoinMarketCap, CoinGecko, TradingView, Coin360. Keep an eye on the market, set some alerts, set some notifications to pop up when certain things happen, certain conditions are hit. And then obviously for tracking for tax purposes or whatever it may be, Coin Tracker or Coin Tracking are good apps to use. And then bonus, keep an eye on your network, keep an eye on your systems, critical updates, especially for Windows. Glasswire and Pulseway, I believe, are primarily for Windows, but I believe Pulseway is available for Linux. Don't quote me on that. But honestly, Linus Tech Tips turned me on to Pulseway, and it's been a great application, not only for my work life, but for my personal as well. That's pretty much going to do it for me today. I'm sorry this video ran a little bit long, but if you got any useful information out of it, please do me a favor. Hit the like button and comment down below. Let me know what you're using. What are your top five apps that you would recommend each crypto miner have in their arsenal? Besides that, make sure you get subscribed. Make sure you hit the notification bell to stay up to date what's going on, as well as check out some of the links in the description that help support us in what we do here, like the dogelord.com, where you get a sweet Serpent X hat and much more. There's many content creators on dogelord.com, and there's coffee, great coffee. I got myself some 6-bean blend, and it does the job quite well. You all have yourself a wonderful day. Take care. I'll catch you next one.